Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through some examples for the selection of a thermostatic as well as electronic expansion valves, as they are the most common valves used in commercial refrigeration applications. Coming up, selecting a thermostatic expansion valve, selecting an electronic expansion valve, generating a report, and generating a bill of materials. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the Coolselector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So do check out the other videos if you haven't already. Links are in the video description below. Since we want to make a selection for a commercial refrigeration system, we can set the preferences to commercial applications in options and then preferences. This option modifies the Coolselector 2 environment to best suit commercial applications. You can get back to any of the predefined preferences anytime, or even create your own custom preferences for your requirements. For further information about the preferences, please check our video about preferences and tools. If we have detailed information about piping and other components in the liquid line, it is better to select expansion valve and other liquid line components using the Components in Series tab, especially when the length of piping is considerable. However, in this example, we would like to focus on expansion valve selection, so we will use the single component selection. We start the selection process for the thermostatic expansion valve by clicking on the Valves and Line Components tab and then selecting the thermostatic expansion valve option. We start from the top left-hand panel. Here we first define the system. We can choose which type of system this will be installed in using the drop-down menu. In this example, we'll use a typical dry expansion system. The schematic will show a representation for the selected system. In this case, it can only be installed in the liquid line, so this is automatically selected. We then choose the refrigerant we'll be using. In this case, we'll be using R448A, so we select that from the drop-down menu. We can then select which type of connection we require. In this case, we'll leave this as all for now. Before we can proceed with a product selection, we should first define the operating conditions. We'll begin with the cooling capacity. In our example, we require an expansion valve with a cooling capacity of 2.5 kilowatts, an evaporation temperature of negative 8 degrees Celsius, and a condensation temperature of 45 degrees Celsius with a subcooling of 3 Kelvin. The mass flow rate and heating capacity have been calculated for us. We also have the option to use heating capacity or mass flow instead of the cooling capacity. These can be selected from the drop-down menu. Under the operating conditions, we have the selection criteria. The application will suggest products which best suit the operating conditions and closely match the selection criteria. In this example, we'll use 100% load and change our distributor pressure drop to 1 bar. Please note that providing a good estimation for the distributor pressure drop is important, as it affects the required pressure drop in the expansion valve and hence the selection directly. The product family section will show product ranges which are applicable to our system definition. We can hover our mouse over the product family titles to see a photo and a brief description of each product. For this example, we'll choose the TUTC product family. The window will now refresh to display product information. Some of the products will be shown with red text. This is warning that there is a compatibility issue with the product and our operating or selection criteria. We can view the warning by hovering our mouse over the warning symbol in the rightmost column. You will notice that one row is highlighted in green. This is the suggested product which most closely matches our requirements. This product will remain green, so we can come back to this if we were to choose another option. You can see the suggested product has a nominal capacity of 2.541 kilowatts at 98% load. We require 2.5 kilowatts at 100% load, so this is the best match. A TXV has a so-called overcapacity and can provide a higher capacity if the superheat exceeds the nominal superheat. As a result, a TXV should never be oversized. It should be selected for 100% of its nominal capacity. The static superheat should be readjusted rather than oversizing the valve. This will better utilize the bandwidth and the valve will work at higher stability. If you would like to see details on the performance and the calculations, you can do so by going to Options, Preferences, Edit Preferences, and then check the Show Performance Curve and Performance Details in the Valves and Line Components tab. You'll then have to save this preference. We mentioned how to create and edit preferences in our video about tools and preferences. Make sure to check that out as well as our other videos. Links are in the video description below. In the lowest section of the window, we have the performance details. Under the performance curve, you can view an interactive graph to see the performance of the valve. The values will change as we move our mouse across the graph. Under the performance details tab, We can find the thermodynamic data for the system, along with a system schematic and a pressure enthalpy chart. In the sub-tabs, we have system details, as well as product-specific data. Under the code number selection tab, we can find the code number, as well as some additional product information. We can then generate a report, as well as a bill of materials, which can be provided to a Danfoss supplier for a quotation. We'll look at how to do that towards the end of this video. Now we want to choose an electronic expansion valve for the same operating conditions, however on a much larger evaporator with a 90 kilowatt capacity. To do that, we start the selection process for an electronic expansion valve by clicking on the New tab and then choose the Valves and Line Components tab. We then select the electronic expansion valve option. You can notice that the system, refrigerant and operating conditions are kept from our previous selection and we do not need to update them again. This enables us to select multiple components for different lines of a system or compare different components with the same functionality for our system. The only parameter we need to change is the cooling capacity, which is different from the previous case. The product families show those relevant to our system. In this example, we'll choose the ETS Calibri valve. Notice that the default selection criteria for electronic expansion valves is different from the thermostatic expansion valve. For air conditioning and refrigeration, we typically use between 70 to 80% load for selecting an electronic expansion valve to give us a reserve for events such as pull down, where we need to cool down fresh goods from a high temperature to a desired level. For low temperature applications, we typically size an electronic expansion valve for 50 to 60%, otherwise the capacity required during pull down might not be sufficient. You will notice that one product will be highlighted with a green row. This is the suggested product which most closely matches our criteria. Once we make a selection, we can then generate a report as well as a bill of materials which can be provided to a Danfoss supplier for a quotation. We can generate a report for our selected products simply by clicking on the report button in the top menu bar. The window will then refresh to display our product report. In the left-hand panel, under items to include in the report, we can add or remove information from our report by selecting or unselecting the items. If you make a change here, simply click the Update button at the top to apply these changes. Additionally, we have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name to the report using the inputs on the top left-hand panel. Again, if you make a change here, then simply click the Update button to apply these. Along the top of the report, we also have various options to export the report. We now want to create a bill of materials for just the thermostatic expansion valve which we selected earlier. We can therefore remove the tab for the electronic expansion valve by clicking on the X. We can generate a bill of materials by clicking on the Bill of Materials button in the top menu bar. Here, the product quantity, product description and code numbers will be displayed. In the left-hand panel, we also have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name using the inputs. If you make a change here, just click the Update button to apply this. Along the top of the Bill of Materials, we also have a number of buttons to export the Bill of Materials. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed this and it has helped you. If so, please don't forget to like, subscribe and share. If you have any questions, let us know in the comment section down below. You can find links to more Coolselector 2 tutorials in the video description below. Do check those out, and once again, thanks for watching.